On behalf of everybody here at the Ozark Hope Center, got a nice show lined out for you tonight. Hey, Mark, will you bring the house lights a little bit up? Let's see who we got here in the audience tonight. Got a nice little house full of people. Even got a few in the front row. What do you know? Who's here for the first time? Never been to the Folk Center before. We got some newcomers. Oh, we do. You folks, way in the back. Where are you from?
Missouri.
Missouri. Okay. Where else?
Texas.
Who else? Huh?
Texas.
Texas?
England.
England. You may win the prize for coming to the front tonight at the Folk Center. Great to have you here. How many people live in Arkansas that are here tonight? Yeah, oh, come on. We got a few anyway, and we're so glad to have you all here. Got a great show lined up for you. Jack and Mary Geiger are here. They do some really nice dulcimer work tonight. Panther Mountain is here. And the band that just played for the square dance there, the Peck of Peppy Pickers. Every MC's nightmare, the Peck of Peppy Pickers. Anyway, whoever they are, they're here tonight. But we're going to start out with some young folks tonight. We like to feature young folks here at the Folk Center. That's one of the things that we're about, is preserving this music and passing it on to the next generation. That's why this place was built in the first place. And we're going to present that to you tonight, because we've got a young lady and some of her friends that do a fine job. Come on out, girls. Don't be bashful. I know they're not bashful, as you're about to see. And Gordon. Hi, Gordon. Young Gordon Parker over there on the mandolin. I played a fiddle the other night. What did you hear about the fiddle? It's outrageous. That's Gresham McMillan. There he goes. That was Gresham McMillan. That's probably all you'll see of him tonight. He's just bringing the bass out. How nice. Grace Stormont playing the bass. Elena Brewer over yonder on guitar. And on the fiddle, my gosh, you can play it too. Young Mary Parker.
Thank you. sat down and told me of a prophet, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, the gauntlet of God. Realm, realm, what the realm, we'll see the wrath of ages, till the Vikings out there read the gospel pages.
this Friday, today, Wednesday, isn't it? A couple of days from now, Dennis Cromack will be here, a Creole fiddler. Plays that Cajun type fiddling, which we like to get up here at the Folk Center every now and again. Compare it with our mountain fiddling. That's Dennis Cromack on October 2nd. The Howland Brothers will be here and on the following Friday, October 10th. The Howland Brothers, a great name for a band, eh? Our Next Generation concert, where it features all young folks, the MC, stage manager, director of the Folk Center that night will be 9 years old, so it's a big event here, the Next Generation concert. And then the Poor Valley Girls will be here on Saturday, October 24th. A few other things to talk to you about, but right now I want to introduce these folks to you. A lady we don't see on the stage too much, I'm glad to see her, Deanne Gillespie, a fine fiddle player.
Actually, it's Deanne Garnett now.
Yeah. Hey, I live out of Fox, I don't hear about this stuff. How long have you been married now?
2.5 years.
Well, no wonder.
News travels slow.
You don't live that far away.
Oh, come on. This is Jack Geiger down here on the guitar. And a lady in the middle with a lovely voice and plays a lot of great instruments, including her little banjo dulcimer she's playing right now, Mary Geiger.
Well, I was going to start off with one of my favorite songs, and lovely to have Deanne here to help us out, called Going Across the Mountains in the Key of C.
A lady came in the dulcimer shop the other day and played a song I've heard
a number of people do it, for Dave Smith do it, and some of my friends over at the Ozark RV Park play it. And I never really attempted it myself, but it must be great to do with Deanne. It's called Sally in the Garden.
I've heard it's a Civil War song.
Is it?
I think so, I have to double check, but it's also just kind of creepy.
Yeah. Get ready for Halloween.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm going down south to have a good time. See my girl in North Carolina. Drink my blues and lose I think. All those girls are on the screen. I'm dreaming about my Dixie darling. That's where I wanna be going. Down where the jelly roll rolls with my Dixie queen. My Dixie darling, listen to the song I sing beneath the silver moon. Banjo all in tune, my heart is ever true. I love no one but you, my Dixie darling, my Dixie queen. Song I sing beneath the silver moon. Banjo all in tune, my heart is ever true. I love no one but you, my Dixie darling, my Dixie queen, my Dixie darling, my Dixie queen.
Popular for country dances, and it's just a peppy little tune called Joys of Quebec. So anybody who knows why people are joyful in Quebec, you can come see us afterwards and let us know.
Settled, right right after the Revolutionary War. He talks about the year of 82. He's not even talking about 1882. He's talking about 1782. You know, nowadays folks marry for love, but they haven't always done that. In fact, next time I'm marrying for money, I'm telling you. But widow women were really in high demand back in the early days when a man needed a woman to take care of him. Well, we still do, don't we? So this is a song called The Widows of Bowling Green. And I'm playing it on a banjo ukulele. This is what happens when you wash your banjo and it'll hop over. Old Kentucky in the year of 82, and Uncle Sam was just a young and hungry lad. The war killed a lot of men and set the women free, and I had the winter fever mighty bad. I sparked him in the country and I sparked him in the town. Every guy I courted was a queen. I nearly lost the fever when a feller said to me that there ain't no winters left in Bowling Green. So hang out the fiddle and the banjo, put up the tambourine. The boys are all coming and they're taking up the land, and there ain't no winters left in Bowling Green. Settled in my old backbone and got into my liver and my spleen. The doctor said he'd cure me, but there's not much he could do, cause there ain't no winters left in Bowling Green. I ordered me a dozen from the state of Carolina, but I haven't earned as lucky ever seen. The neighbors stopped the wagon train and took them every one, and there ain't no winters left in Bowling Green. So hang up the fiddle and the banjo, put up the tambourine. The boys are all coming and they're taking up the land, and there ain't no winters left in Bowling Green. Big break. Lonesome on the shelf. If I could live without one for about 100 years, then maybe I could make it by myself. There's widders down in Jersey, and there's widders up in Maine. They say they got them down in New Orleans. There's widders up in Canada and down in Mexico, but there ain't no widders left in Bowling Green. So hang up the fiddle and the banjo, put up the tambourine. The boys are all coming and they're taking up the land, and there ain't no widders left in Bowling Green. Mouthbow. His father-in-law, Jess Goodman, who had a store in Oney, Arkansas, played the mouthbow a lot. They said Jimmy had still had it in his collection when he passed, and I'm sure it's somewhere still. They said it was completely coated with amber. Amber being another word for old dried used chewing tobacco. You can imagine how it got all over it. But you play it by tightening up the string, all right? More. Hold it up against the side of your mouth and change the shape of your mouth to change the note. Try a little tune for you here. Shoulder up your gun and whistle up your dog. Shoulder up your gun and whistle up your dog. We're gonna hunt that old brown hog in the dungeons around the game. Eat the meat and save the hide. Eat the meat and save the hide. Make the best shoestrings ever was tied. Yinkadum-yinkadum-yay. Yonder comes Gal, yonder comes Sal with a snigger and a grin. Yonder comes Sal with a snigger and a grin. Got groundhog gravy all over her chin. You can tell me, yeah. There's a little piece of cornbread laying on the shelf. Little piece of cornbread laying on the shelf. If you want any more, have a second yourself. You can tell me, yeah. All right. Okay, play on. for you. I like that. I love the poems and songs of Robert Burns, the famous Scottish poet and songwriter. Famous to this day, all over the world, really. This is one of his songs about the Afton River. And he liked birds a lot. He always sang about birds in his songs. You mentioned this. This is Flow Gently, Sweet Afton. Flow gently, sweet Afton, among thy green braes. Flow gently, sweet river, the theme of my lays. My Mary's asleep by thy murmuring stream. Flow gently, sweet Afton, disturb not her dream. Thou stock dove whose echo resounds through the glen, ye wild whistly blackbird in yon thorny den, thou green crested lapwing, thy screaming forbear, I charge thee disturb not my slumbering fair. How lofty, sweet Afton, thy neighboring hills, far marked with the courses of clear winding rills, where daily I wander as noon rises high, my flocks and my Mary's sweet cot in my eye. How gentle thy banks and green valleys below, where wild in the woodlands the primroses glow, where oft as mild evening sweeps over the lea, the sweet smelling birk shades my Mary and me. Thy crystal stream, Afton, how lovely it glides, winds by the cot where my Mary resides. How wanton thy waters her snowy feet lay, as gathering sweet flowers she stems thy clear way. Flow gently, sweet Afton, among thy green braes. Flow gently, sweet river, theme of my lays. My Mary is asleep by thy murmuring stream. So flow gently, sweet Afton, disturb not her dream. Not this last century, but the one before that. Probably a true story. Oh, I wish I'd had 50 cents. Now it'd be 50 bucks, I guess. I wish that you could see the gal I took to a fancy ball. The span around her little waist was neat and very small. I thought about two oysters would fill her up complete. Such a dainty little delicate thing. But this is what she eat. A dozen raw, a plate of slaw, a fancy Boston roast, a bowl of stew with crackers too, soft crab served on toast. Next to rise, some oysters fried. I thought she had more sense. When she called for pie, I thought I'd die for a half of 50 cents. She said she wasn't hungry, she didn't care to eat, but I got money in my pants to say she can't be beat. She took it in so easy, she had an awful tank. She said she wasn't thirsty, but this is what she drank. A brandy gun, hot buttered rum, three schooners of lager beer, a glass of ale and a gin cocktail, it quickly disappeared. Then a whiskey skin and a glass of gin, she astonished all the gents. When she called for more, I fell to the floor for a half and 50 cents. She said she'd bring her family along next time we went for fun. I give the man my 50 cents, and this is what he done. He broke my nose, he tore my clothes, he threw me through the door. I won the prize with two black eyes, with me he mopped the floor. Then he grabbed me where my pants hang loosely, threw me right over the fence. Take my advice, don't try it twice if you have but 50 cents. Well, I don't have my banjo, or I would do my garbage. I don't know how to play on this.
Bottom land.
The barn. Okay.
Oh, the barn.
I'll do this song. We're allowed to do one little bit newer song every night, as long as it pertains to the Ozarks. And this pertains to me, actually, because this song came to me when I was building my barn out in Fox back about 15 years ago or so. My two sons, Jed and Austin, as some of you know, were helping me build the barn. And that song came along just at the same time. It means a lot to me. I hope that long after I'm gone, my boys will come back down to the Fox and look at the barn they helped build when they were kids. And this is a song that was written about a true story by a man from Colorado named Bob Amos. It's called Mr. Beeford's Barn. August 1969, after evening chores, we went to see who stood outside knocking on our door. An old man stood there quietly, his hat held in his hand. He said, I'd like to have a minute of your time. You see, my dad and I, we built that barn in 1899. He said his name was Beeford as we walked across the field. And he told us how they'd raised the frame without a single nail. Just wooden pegs was all it took to make those timbers stand. Then he said, as his eyes looked far away, build it right, and it will last forever. Mr. Beeford's barn still stands on our farm, where it stood 100 years before. Solid as the rock that it was built upon, it will stand 100 years more. Told us how they'd moved down south in 1921, where farming was much easier and the winters not as long. But he made a promise to himself to see the barn again once more before his life was done. Then he shook our hands and drove away into the setting sun. Late that night, I gazed out of the window by my bed, and out across the meadow while the moon shone overhead. The old barn stood there silver like a sentry in the night. Once more, I heard the old man say, build it right, and it will last forever. Mr. Beeford's barn still stands on our farm, where it stood 100 years before.
solid as the rock that it once built upon, it will stand 100 years more. Solid as the rock that it was built upon, it will stand 100 years
Howdy.
How y'all?
I'm doing a lot better. For any of you that heard about me, first they said they cut my leg off, but I hadn't even made it to the hospital yet. But news travels fast around here. I'm gonna dig an old lonesome dog.
Oh, wait, no.
carry you to freedom if you follow the dripping cord. The riverbank makes a mighty good road. Dead trees will show you the way. Left foot, peg foot, traveling on. Follow the
down yonder. Hey, Rachel. Otherwise known as Rudy Pine. That's her daddy, Larry Snyder, on the five-string banjo. And the final fiddler is your final in the Ozark, Mr. Roger Crump. Not you.
Oh, Till she gave a full heart rest. She was my world, my darling Patty. And now she's gone, God knows where. And it's been a mile I've been down this road. And many a mile I've been down.
I wish I not that we're not organized, don't think that. We're just, you know, working on the fine points.
I knew I was just trying to be really polite.
We're all standing around waiting for somebody to start the song.
I was thinking
So that's the name of the tune, and we're going to give it a shot. Well, Gary finally got it. Well, John, well, okay. Anyway. All right, let's try it.